Good evening and welcome to Hopkinton High School for tonight's varsity basketball game against the Bellingham Blackhawks. The Tri-Valley League is committed to the highest ideals of sportsmanship and establishing a healthy environment for interscholastic competition. The league will not tolerate negative statements or actions directed towards competitors, game officials, or fans in attendance. Such actions, including taunting, trash-talking, and berating of officials or players, will not be tolerated. The Tri-Valley League has adopted a zero-tolerance policy. Warnings will not be issued and offenders will be ejected. Please respect all decisions made by officials. Please respect fans, coaches, participants, and opponents alike. And now, the lineups for this evening's game. For the Bellingham Blackhawks, number 14, sophomore Maddie Mantegani. Number 21, freshman Caitlin Repose. Number 5, senior Jade Figueroa. Number 4, junior captain Jesse Magerman. Number 22, junior captain Liz Sender. Bellingham is coached by Stacey Bilodeau and Megan Popolo. And now for your hometown Hopkinton Hillers. Starting at guard, number 33, junior Kate Huber. Starting at guard, number 10, senior Julia Pinastrari. Starting at forward, number 44, junior captain Abby Vogelin. Starting at guard, number 12, senior captain Emil Kasha. Starting at forward, number 31, senior captain Michaela Pucci. The coaches for the Hillers are Mike Greco, Perry Chatton, and Kristen Balbaga. Would you all please rise for the playing of our national anthem?
Tim Hladek and Steve Spector here with you tonight on a rainy, cold Tuesday evening as HKM presents another showing of Hillers girls basketball. Tonight, the Bellingham Blackhawks visit the Hiller Arena to face the 12-2 first place in the TVL Hopkinton Hillers.
Hey, Steve Spector here with Tim, and we were here Friday night. It was a full house, senior night, if I'm not mistaken. Was it senior
right,
night?
Right, yes,
and,
it was, yep.
You know, it was a great, great match, and tonight is a little different situation with a kind of a tough weather night and a lot fewer people in the stands,
right.
And Bellingham coming in here with a kind of a short-looking bench with some underclassmen, including some eighth graders.
Right.
So we'll have to see how this one goes, Tim.
Right. Hopkinton took the first meeting on January 6th, winning 61-23 as Canestrari opens the game with an easy deuce.
That's their typical opening play, which ran like clockwork.
Again, as you mentioned, Bellingham only two players on the bench, and then five of their regular roster being eighth graders. So definitely a tall task to climb as Ivy Gogolin makes it 4-0. A tall hill to climb, no pun intended, for this Blackhawk team.
Ooh, unfortunate. Ooh. That's too bad. Jesse Magerman of Bellingham got tripped up accidentally and do the foul there. and Bellingham still has the ball.
That foul goes to Kate Huebner, her first of the game.
Not sure what happened there, Tim. Maybe the Hiller knocked the ball out of bounds, but it's still Bellingham ball.
I thought I had heard that the clock hadn't started, which is why he stopped play.
Got it. That would make sense.
Yeah, it didn't look like the ball went out of bounds.
Exactly. So we have I had a chance before the game to speak to a couple of the Hiller players, Lily Morningstar and Regan Keaveney. Both are out with some injuries. Regan has a sort of a toe injury, and Lily has some shin splints, but they're resting up for the rest of the season
right.
And getting ready for the playoffs. So this appears, at least on paper, that it might not be a bad game to do that.
Right.
With their next game is Friday. I don't know if you have the schedule in front
yep,
of you.
Yep, at Millis on Friday and then at Medway on next Tuesday.
So the pretty busy schedule coming up. And then
right.
I think a week from Friday we have Westwood home.
Yep, home. So three games against the top of the TVL here to finish off the season.
Yeah, so this will be interesting. In looking at the roster for Bellingham, it's tough to see some eighth grade girls on that roster for a varsity team, but
right.
That's what they're bringing to the game. And mm-hmm. you get to play the game out, and
right.
I'm sure they'll be competitive as best they can.
Magerman brings it up for Bellingham after taking that nasty fall. She looks okay. Ball dribbled out of bounds. Looked like it went off of Pucci's foot. Don't know how it would have gone out of bounds otherwise, but here the Hillers end up with the ball. Lakasha controlling it for the Hillers. Gogolin puts it up. Nothing but net. 4 points early for Ivy Gogolin.
There's not much Bellingham can offer in the way of guarding a 6'1" center like Ivy
mm-hmm.
or forward, but she's any kind of height. Julia is also about 6 feet tall,
right.
So that's going to be an uphill battle for Bellingham.
Mm-hmm. Typically the case, though, with any team coming in to play the Hillers.
Feels like it's sort
right.
of redundant. We've been saying that a lot in the last few games here, but that's
right.
that's the case, and it might be even more so tonight.
But it remains true nonetheless.
Nice play by Magerman.
And Liz Sender banks it in for Bellingham's first points. Pass inside to Gogolin, taken away. Caitlin Repose seals it away. She drives
nice
the whole way and gets it the hard bank to fall in.
Maybe I spoke too soon, Tim. I mean, those were two really nice baskets by Bellingham.
Now just a 2-point lead for the Hillers. Hopkinton trying to probe this Blackhawk defense. Whipping the ball around the 3-point line. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Ball inside to Gogol, and she fakes, drives. Nice drive, but can't finish. Ball, loose ball, grabbed by Sender of Bellingham.
Good
now
defense.
In the hands of Repose. A quick shot from the wing, no good, bounces out. Shot no good from Maddie Mantegani. Huebner finds a cutting Gogol, and nice pass. Shot just a bit too strong. Pucci, offensive board. She takes the foul and will be shooting two at the line.
Caitlin Marposi basically stood there with her hands up, and Pucci, I would say, initiated the contact there, and there was contact, but I guess the ref saw a foul on Rapuzzi on that one. Rapuzzi, I'm sorry. Michaela hit the first one, I think.
Yep. Second one good as well.
Lots of different aspects of the game, Tim. We've seen in other games where the free throw shooting hasn't been exactly stellar on the
right.
part of the Hillers, but it's good to see them start with a couple of free throws.
The runner from Jesse Magerman just trickles out, goes out of bounds off of a Hiller. Now back in the hands of Magerman. Now to Raposi. Ball taken away by Canestrari. She's forced out of bounds and turns it right back over to Bellingham.
Yeah, there's a ball handling at the top for Bellingham. He's seen a little bit of a – we've been challenged by the Hillers, and Canestrari got the steal and unfortunately landed out of bounds, but ball's back to Bellingham at the moment.
Shot fired again just inside the three-point line. No good from Maddie Mantegani.
Nice block.
Sender has a loose ball. She can't finish and grabbed by Gogolin. Now Pucci wide open. Nice pass from Lakasha. Pucci can't make the easy layup. Uncharacteristic of her. And now Mantegani runs down the floor with it for Bellingham.
That's too bad on Michaela's part. She ran out of real estate there.
Jade Figueroa can't handle the pass. Loses it. Now Gogolin finally with some fancy handwork over there by the basket. She can't finish either. Now Bellingham's on the run.
Nice move by Magerman.
Quick shot fired again from three-point line. Mantegani.
Up and down here.
Huebner drives. Opens
nice
up
play.
A lane. Great drive from Kate Huebner. Taking advantage of her starting role today.
That's a good opportunity for her. Looks like Lily's out, so. Huebner's, she's been earning her playing time for sure in the last few games that we've seen.
Magerman misses the quick layup. Gogolin with the rebound. Canestrari takes it the whole way, and her layup trickles in. That opens up a 12-4 lead and a timeout, Bellingham.
Not a bad call by Coach Bilodeau of Bellingham, kind of keeping things somewhat under control. They're down 12-4 at the moment with about 4 minutes left in the first quarter, and it's kind of been an up-and-down situation, and the Hillers actually have had a few layups that have kind of haven't made their way in there, but at the very end, Julia made a nice play with a little English off the glass to give them a 12-4 lead, and that was enough to have the Blackhawks coach kind of reel it in for a minute and get called timeout.
And not many playing styles are going to favor the Blackhawks here today, but this one, this quick pace up and down the court will definitely not favor them with only two players on the bench. They'll be running themselves out of energy sooner rather than later. Meanwhile, we see Hawkinson, even with the injuries to Keaveney and Morningstar, they still have a very deep bench.
It looks like an army over there of a sea of white.
Right, a sea of Hillers.
Exactly, which is not a bad thing, and because we're Hillers ourselves. at least I – well,
partially.
I know you're sort of from Medway. but
an adopted son.
That's okay. We're going to let it go for tonight. But we certainly – are excited to see the Hillers off to a good start so far tonight.
Ball gets into Magerman, captain of this Bellingham squad.
She looks to be the ringleader out there, the director.
Fires the floater, a bit too strong, but offensive rebound grabbed by Dussault. And in a tie-up with Mercer Prawl, she is called for a travel, so ball awarded to the Hillers.
Boy, Marissa Prawl was smothered her along with Julia, and there was just no place to go for that sort of shorter in stature Bellingham player.
Turnover there from Mafior. Speaking of Mafior, she, Prawl, and Callie Corby have made their first appearance in this game. Tip pass from Canestrari. Gogolin recovers the loose ball. Mafior finds an open Prawl cutting. She takes the contact. Nice play from Mafior to Prawl, and she's rewarded with two free throws.
Yeah, nice play by Marissa taking it to the hoop. Really no place for the Bellingham girl to go, and it was a pretty good contact there. Both officials called the foul there. There's three officials here tonight, but two of them called the foul there.
First free throw good for Prawl. Second
nice.
One good as well. 4-for-4 from the line early for Hopkinton here in the first.
Good to see Marissa get a couple free throws in there.
Magerman drives, throws up the tough shot. Bit too strong, but falling right in the hands of Caitlin Repose. She gets her first points here. Actually, no, she had a shot earlier. That's her third and fourth point here tonight.
She's a pretty tall girl, Repose. Oh, nice block by her.
Yeah, on the defensive end as well, blocking Ivy Gogolin.
Only a freshman. She's about 6 feet tall. We don't have the official heights, but she's looking eye to eye with Ivy.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like the Hiller cheerleaders are beginning to filter in, which should only help the situation. Add some positive energy to the building.
Bellingham inbounds, down 14-6, 2:38 left in the first quarter. Tough play there, trying to get the ball to Repose as Candace Dry was draped all over her. Ball out of bounds, stays with Bellingham. Now Huebner and Pucci make their way back into the game. Canastrari and Gogolin take a rest. Magerman rushes down the court with a pass. Hits teammate Sydney Connor. She cannot finish. And now Prawl finds herself by herself. Grabs the foul.
Wow, she's got some wheels. She was flying down the lane there. And as she got to the hoop, she got whacked in the arm. So her second time in the line, she's 2 for 2. So maybe she can keep it going here. Wow, she's got a good stroke there. That's her third swish in a row, so good to see her get some points early.
Fourth one up and good. Boy, another swish.
She's got really good routine. That's all.
Every shot has been the same.
Sort of robotic, which is what you want at a free throw, exactly. And she's got a really good motion there. That's great.
Loose ball now. Repose falls on it.
Good hustle.
Now Repose has it back at the three-point line. She's looking to get her shot. She does. A little bit short. It falls out of bounds. Hillers take over.
Geez, that's some good moves by Repose. I think we're pronouncing her name right.
I believe so.
She gets some nice rotation there. She just kind of came up short in that shot, but so some good moves there for the freshman.
Huebner from three, knocks it down. I believe that's the first three-pointer of the game for Hopkinton.
Oh, nice shot.
As Repose answers down the other end with a two of her own. Now a 19-8 lead for Hopkinton. A minute and a half left here in the first quarter. Pucci inside, kicks it over. Prawl for three. No good from her. Huebner fights in there for the rebound, gets it, and turns it right over to Magerman. Magerman, the quick pass to Sydney Connor. She can't handle it. Goes out of bounds. Hillers take over again off the Bellingham turnover.
It's a 19-8 lead with about a minute left in the first quarter. So far, so good for the Hillers. Bellingham's playing a 1-2-2 zone most of this quarter.
Hopkinton with methodical passes trying to probe the zone. A good job doing it so far as Pucci gets down low, left hand. Doesn't quite make it and then grabbed by
Liz Sender.
Liz Sender, yep.
One of the captains.
Quick shot, no good from Jade Figueroa, and now Pucci controls it. Prawl looks up.
Oh, too bad.
Right idea to try to get it down to Huebner. A bit too much on that pass. Turnover Hopkinton. And now Prawl and Corby will take a rest as looks like Gogolin comes back onto the floor and Emma Lakasha.
That's a pretty deep bench here. Maybe working for one shot before. Oh, she's in trouble now.
Great defense from Gogolin and Huebner. Magerman doesn't know what to do. Turns it over. Lakasha looks up, finds Pucci. Too strong. Pucci with a great pass to Gogolin. Partially blocked, maybe blocked again by Repose. Great play, but Gogolin muscles it through.
Jeez, I don't know. That was amazing. The ball made its way in the hoop. Oh, that's a good shot.
End of the quarter, buzzer beater.
Wow.
From Maddie Mantegani. Some life here for Bellingham at the end of the first.
Well, I think that made the score 21 to 11 if they counting the three-pointer, if my math is correct.
Right.
We haven't seen the score updated quite yet, but.
There we go.
And we have the Hiller cheerleaders that are going to take over for a minute. Yep, the scoreboard is on the screen is correct, Tim. It's at 21-11, mm-hmm. and they just corrected it here in the athletic center. But that was a heck of a shot by Jade Figueroa, I think.
Mantegani, 14.
Number 14, yep. Maddie Mantegani released that with about a half a second to go in the quarter, and it found its way through to keep the first quarter score fairly respectable. The Hillers have a 10-point lead.
Right, and we used our instant replay up here. We saw it was good. It did leave the hands, so we'll give it to her. And Bellingham, like you said, they did need it. So otherwise would have been 21-8 going into the second quarter here. And ultimately, I don't think it will. I think you are the same mindset. It probably won't matter here coming down towards the end. But as of now, Bellingham's still within striking distance.
Yeah, I think, you know, you mentioned right out of the gate that there might be an issue of endurance, which is normal human behavior when you have eight or nine girls on the roster. So as this game gets along, we'll have to see how that plays out. But I think for now, you got to tip your hat to Bellingham for hanging in there pretty good.
Lakasha starts things off here in the second quarter. Again, Bellingham still in their zone. And Hopkinton circulating the ball around, trying to break that zone, gets inside to Gogol, and she stops a little too short on the shot, grabbed by Repose. Pass down low to Sender. Gogolin blocks it.
She blocked it and kept it in play, which is a Bill Russell special for your old-timers out there.
Nice drive from Huebner, gets it into Pucci. Pucci cannot finish by the rim.
No, she's...
And Gogolin gets in front of Repose and takes the charge.
Well, some of the Bellingham parents were not quite in agreement with that call. just ran out of real estate. There's this.
Right.
Julia did a great job sealing the sideline. There was just no place to go, and the Bellingham girl ran her over from my perspective up here.
Gogolin inside, turns, kicks it to Canestrari. She fires the three, a bit short. And now Magerman has it for Bellingham. Magerman again in trouble, doubled by Huebner and Canestrari.
Nice play.
She finds the open player. Figueroa knocks it down.
Nice play by Magerman. One of the captains of Bellingham, a junior. She's kind of the lifeblood of the team at the moment. She handles the ball really well and made a beautiful pass.
Pucci down low, uses her body, muscles it through Repose.
She had missed a few earlier, so she was determined. You could see the fire in her eyes on that one from here.
Magerman bounce pass down low to Sender. Sender blocked from maybe Canestrari and Gogolin.
Well, unfortunate.
But a loose ball. I think off someone's foot out of bounds, off of a Hiller's foot in any event. Blackhawks take over.
Yeah, it looked like just took a funny bounce off a Hiller foot and then through the wickets of someone and then out of bounds. So it's Bellingham ball, as you said.
Repose looking for someone.
That's about a seven. Yep, there we go.
Repose tried a wily play here for a freshman. Throws it off of Pucci's leg there, but a bit too late.
Yeah, should have done a couple seconds earlier. I think she would have worked out pretty good.
Canestrari drives baseline. Throws up the tough
nice
shot.
Block by
Sender, I believe.
Repose.
Gogolin, or excuse me, Huebner comes up with the loose ball at the block shot and knocks down a free throw line jumper. 25-13 lead now for Hopkinton. Sender takes contact, tries to force up the shot, and is rewarded with a foul.
Michaela Pucci wasn't in a complete agreement with that call, but there was a bunch of contact there, and ref kind of bailed her out in that because she was really kind of trapped between two or three Hiller girls there.
Sender knocks down the free throw.
25-14, Hillers.
Second one good as well.
Pretty good player there. I'll say this, the girls that are playing for Bellingham, they're hanging in there pretty well.
They're playing well, keeping them in the game. Still only down 10. Gogolin turns around, fires the shot. Doesn't quite get it to fall. Pucci turns. Sender hit with the foul, and Pucci will get two more free throws.
We'll have to see how many fouls that is on her. But I think, as this game gets along, if any one of those taller girls for Bellingham getting any foul trouble, this could be, I don't know who they go to put the coaches in there. One of them looks pretty tall, but I think that was Sender's second foul. She just got taken out of the game.
Pucci's second one falls through. 11-point lead now for Hopkinton. Magerman stuck in the corner, doesn't know quite what to do, does manage to get it out of trouble, now in the hands of Mantegani.
Pretty good composure for the junior.
Shoots the wide open three, wasn't quite set, off the mark. Now Huebner with it, the nice pass to Canestrari, who calmly lays it down for two.
Nice finish there, nice pass.
Magerman with it now at the three-point line. Drives, then gives it up. Pass stolen. Now Canestrari takes it all the way for the easy two. Four quick points for her.
Relentless full-court pressure. I wouldn't call it a press, but kind of no mercy.
Three for Mantegani. No good. Gogolin grabs the board. Now Hopkinton on the break
nice
again.
Pass.
Pucci runs down the whole way, catches the Bellingham defense sleeping. Another 2 points for Michaela Pucci. And it looks like Sender is coming right back in.
Yeah, you can kind of see that one happening from up here. We have a nice angle to see a nice pass.
Pucci always looking for those fast break points, and she gets another one there. The floater from Magerman, no good. Now Hopkinton on the break again. Canestrari looks down low to Gogolin, and it is now.
I have to call a timeout. Somebody to get a bunch of girls looking to get in the game.
Defense unraveling here for Bellingham. As soon as Sender went out, three easy buckets down by the hoop.
Yeah, that was all of a sudden the lead blossomed to 19 points. And
about three baskets
ago, there were girls waiting to get into the game, and there were three really quick fast break points on the Hillers part, and certainly an opportunity to get some other players in the game, and it's good that the Bellingham coach called a timeout to allow that to happen. But we'll have to dig deep into our sort of a sports trivia as this game goes along. We'll see, but while we have a moment, we should talk about our crack team here.
Of course. Our producers here today, John Ritz and Mike Terosian. Our director, Mr. Tom Dings. Graphics, Samantha Dings. And our cameras here tonight, Bob Hamilton, John Ritz. Thank you guys for doing a great job.
Yep. We'll have to double check on some of that personnel. I think we're having a... Okay. So we'll get that together. But what I wanted to say is, on Friday night when we had the senior night here, mm-hmm. I made a prediction for the Super Bowl score, and I thought it was going to be a blowout, 41-20 Patriots.
Yep.
So I'm glad I was incorrect with the blowout part, but I'm glad they won. So I just wanted we had some time to get that in there. So
owning up to it, I like it.
Yep.
Hillers have a 19-point lead, like Steve said, right before the timeout there. 3:30 left here in the first half. Ball down low to Sender. She turns, fires, nothing but net.
Nice shot. She's a nice player. Tipped.
Ball
Magerman.
Knocked away from Lakasha. Now Magerman controls. Mantegani fires a quick shot. The three bounces around, almost trickles in. Now in the hands of Prawl. And Hockington patiently passing the ball around, trying to break this zone.
10 seconds on the shot clock.
Corby drives, puts up the shot, can't get it. Gogolin with the rebound. She's blocked by Sender. Multiple blocks now for Sender here.
She's playing a good first half.
Mantegani fires a quick three again, this one.
Tough to block Ivy's shot, but she did.
No good, and now Corby finds herself baseline jumper, a bit too strong. And Sender grabs the board. Loose ball out of bounds, stays with Bellingham.
Lauren Hamm coming in the game.
Her first appearance here tonight.
Lauren had a heck of a game Friday night on senior night. Hit a three or four.
Came in and started bombing threes.
Hit them from the parking lot that night, as I recall. But they were launching them, and most of them were going in for her, so that was great.
See if she can duplicate that performance here tonight.
That'd be good.
Now she doesn't have to wait till the fourth quarter for this one.
There you go.
Shot from repose. No good. Matt Fior fighting for the rebound. Ends up in the hands of Corby, and Repose hit with the reach-in.
That's another foul on her. Again, I think that's two on her. They have to keep an eye on that situation. They're two big girls. Both have two fouls, I believe. So.
Ashley McDermott makes her first appearance in this game.
Nice pass.
Mafiore inside, kicks it over to Hamm. Now back in the hands of Prawl. Mafior inside, drives, scoops. Layup does not fall, but a foul. Another costly foul here for Bellingham. We'll see who this one's called on. Mafior gets two more free throws. First free throw rattles around, no good for Mafior.
Allie also had a really good game senior night on Friday night. It was a... quite the blowout, 69-31.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. This one appears to be on the same track.
The last few Hopkinton games have been blowouts with wins over Dover Sherburne, Medfield, and Holliston, all wins by over 20 points. This Hiller team, not much is going to stop them
block.
As McDermott registers a block. Gets her name on the stat sheet here tonight. Foul. Against Bellingham from behind. Prawl draws the contact. This one going against.
It looks to be a one-on-one situation.
Haley DeSalt.
I would say.
And you are right, yep.
Some of the Bellingham parents were not particularly thrilled with that call. And mm-hmm. You know,
voicing their opinions.
Yeah, well, I know we say that every once in a while, but in this particular case, given the score and given that the magnitude of that foul, it wasn't really a big deal from my perspective. But so I guess I'm gonna give the Bellingham parents have benefit of the doubt in that one. I think they were right.
Lauren Hamm for three. No good. Her first shot of the game. McDermott grabs the board.
Ooh, unlucky.
Can't finish. Gets another rebound. Feels Sender behind her. Another shot. No good. And Sender rips this one away. Aggressive on-ball defense here from Lauren Hamm. Causes a loose ball.
Ooh.
From Figueroa. Sender comes up with it and turns into a shot and is fouled by Liberta. Mr. Spector's neighbor here getting some early game time.
There we go. Well, thanks for pointing that out. Yeah, Elizabeth is one of the four Liberta children who have been raised in Hopkinton. Great family. Doug and Patty Liberta. Well done, guys.
If you're listening.
Yep.
First shot from Sender, no good. Second one up. Off the front rim, grabbed by McDermott. Now Prawl on the break. 35 seconds left here in the first half. A quick first half. By my standards, anyway.
It's going quickly.
As a loose ball results in a jump ball, this one goes to Bellingham.
Hiller's no mercy whatsoever. Full court press with a 17 points. That's, you got to say, that's pretty respectable under the circumstances.
Right. And if it wasn't for that quick 10-point run Hopkinton had, this game would be far closer right now. Still within striking distance. A turnover there. McDermott grabs a steal. Gets it in the hands of a guard.
With 10 seconds left.
Corby open for three. Play. Turns it up. Gets a better shot from Liberta, who knocks it down. Elizabeth Liberta, her first points of the game. And Magerman does not.
Did I tell you that was my neighbor? My former neighbor? No, good for Elizabeth. Great shot. And I'm sorry I interrupted you. I was so overcome with emotion on that shot by Elizabeth.
A lot of excitement in the air here. But with that, Liberta's shot gives the Hillers a 19-point lead, taking a 36-17 advantage into the halftime break.
Yeah, looking pretty good so far. And I think there'll be plenty of opportunity for plenty of the Hiller girls to get some playing time all the way down the bench. And we've already seen a lot of that. So everybody stay tuned for what will definitely be an exciting second half of basketball here.
And we're going to hand it off here to the Hopkinton Hiller cheerleaders, and we'll see you after the break.
What it takes.
Will you make a difference?
Always an adventure.
Police and fire working together.
Utilizing the latest technology.
Do you have what it takes?
Are you worried about letting your child take the wheel? Maybe you should also be worried about what you're doing behind the wheel. Have you ever sent a quick text, just this once? Well, that might turn into a catastrophic accident. Monkey see what monkey do. If you do it, why wouldn't your child? In a child's brain, almost all things their parents do, they can do too. 78% of teen drivers surveyed text and drive. 59% said their parents do it too. Stop texting and driving, because if you do it, your child will too.
Tim Hladek and Steve Spector here back with you for the second half. Hopkinton with a 36-17 point advantage going into the third quarter. Looking to make it 10 in a row here and stay atop the TVL.
Yeah, they're off to a good start, and they've had an opportunity to get a lot of different players in the game. They've probably gone at least 10 deep, which is great. Mm-hmm. And got to tip your hat to the Bellingham Blackhawks or kind of hanging around. I think it's still kind of still going to be a tough battle for them, but you got to give them credit. They're really fighting and dealing with the Hiller press reasonably well. And we'll start the second half.
Again, Bellingham still in the 1-2-1 defensively. Hopkinton forced to pass it around, try to find an open shot. They do. Gogolin down low. The nice feed from Kate Huebner. Gogolin with another basket.
Kind of easy pickings on that one.
Sender gets the ball from Magerman, knocked out of her hands. A little smile there from Akasha. I think even she knows should have been Bellingham ball.
I think that was a hometown discount on that call there. I don't know.
I'd have to agree with you there. Yep.
Well, they got a 21-point lead, so no, I think they missed that one, but Got to play on.
Oh. Ball inside to Gogolin. She took her eyes off it, I believe, a second before she caught it, planning her next move.
It was a good idea. She had a whole lane if she just held onto the ball, but that was just kind of moved a half a second too soon on that one.
Magaman bounce pass to Repose. Her shot just a bit short. Now Pucci has it. Huebner running the length of the court. Finds Gogolin down low. Nice pass. Gogolin can't finish. Gets her own rebound and puts it in this time with the left hand.
Yeah, Jade Figueroa, who looks to be about 5'2 or 5'3, giving up a whole bunch of height, and Ivy kind of had her way in that particular instant.
Magerman gets the ball stolen by Huebner. Nice Huebner
hustle.
On the ground, takes it away, gives it to Canestrari, and she finishes. The Tommy point there for Kate Huebner.
I would say Tommy point. Well done. Good call on that one.
Thank you. Canestrari, tough defense on Mantegani, and that forces the turnover. Now Lakasha with it. Picked up her dribble, stuck, needs help, gets Gogolin. Gogolin down low to Pucci. She makes a shot, looks like Repose, I believe, caught a stray elbow there from Pucci, and we are stopping play momentarily.
Well, good. I'm sorry to see that, obviously, and she looks like she took something, an elbow or something, to her forehead, and hopefully it won't be anything serious. The good news is one of the best athletic trainers on the planet, Jeanette Emerson. I'm a little biased. She lives across the street from me.
Everyone's your neighbor.
Yeah, it's a good. Well, we're lucky about that. She and Maura White do a great job here. So whenever anything like this happens, they're on either team. They're in good hands with, in this case, Jeanette tonight. It's also good to have Jeanette in the neighborhood in case there's any injuries in the neighborhoods,
right.
Which we've had to go to her a couple times over the years. But let's hope
this is the last time we see her here tonight.
There you go. Yeah.
Looks as Repose gets to her feet and slowly walks off the court.
That's a big loss. There's plenty of time left in the game, and that certainly is quite a loss. Hopefully it's nothing serious and she can shake it off and get back in the game. If it's anything more than that, they have a concussion protocol, which I'm sure they have to sort of go through.
And it looks like she's going through that with her over there on the bench right now.
Yep.
Gameplay continues. Just under 6 minutes left here in the third. Hiller's up 44-17. Quick three from Mantegani off the hands of Sydney Connor. Out of bounds. And the Hillers take over.
Well, we have an eternity left in the game with a 27-point lead, so we're going to have to keep things fresh up here, Tim. I'm counting on you.
Yeah, hey, so, I'll do what I can.
Yeah, we're hanging in there so far, but the Hiller girls are certainly good. It's a good situation to get a lot of people in the game and get some playing time and spread things around. So,
Prawl's three-point shot, no good as it hits off the rim and bounces on top of the basket, called out of bounds. And Bellingham takes over now in the hands of Magerman, who's been hustling up and down the court all day and needs a little help here from her teammates if they hope to come back in this one. Mantegani down low to Sender, pass disrupted by McDermott, taken by Hawkinson. Prawl thought about the three. Again, Hopkinton still passing it around. Now Prawl shoots the three. No good, but McDermott saw it coming. Got herself in position for the offensive rebound, but can't finish. And now Sender controls it for Bellingham. Mantegani thought about the shot. Nice pass to Sender, who beats McDermott.
Boy, Sender, she must have close to 10 points of the 19 that they have, or maybe 21 now, so I've lost track. No, I guess 19, but she's a nice player. She's a junior. She'll be around for next year as well.
Matt Fiore gets the ball inside. Can't control the pass. Sender forces a jump ball. This one goes to Bellingham. Again, the Hillers are 12-2 overall, 12-1 in the TVL, winners of 9 in a row. Their last loss coming to Coyle Cassidy in a non-league game. that one, I believe, by 11 points. And since then, they have just been on an absolute tear.
Boy, they're on a roll for sure. So
it's been over a month, almost 2 months since they've lost their last game.
I want to say it's the one we did. They lost a really tough one at the end.
Right, to Medfield. That was before the Coyle Cassidy game.
That's
but
right.
that was the one that they gave away at the end.
Hopefully that won't come back and bite them a little bit, but they're
right.
They're certainly well positioned to get a high seed. And there's a
shot clock violation there on Bellingham.
Not only did Bellingham not realize the shot clock was winding down, neither did we. But I'm like, what's that buzzing sound?
You're
it's a 30 second shot clock.
We're not playing though. And we mentioned Bellingham, 3-13 before. Overall, 3-13, 1-13 in the TVL. But as we talked about before, 5 8th graders on their team, and just one senior in Jade Figueroa. So all of these girls are going to be back next year with a year of experience under their belts.
I'm sure they'll have a rebuilding year this year and come back strong next year.
Sender down low gets that one to trickle in. 44-21 now. Hopkinton.
The Hiller girls haven't figured her out yet because she's probably the leading scorer of the game at this point.
Mafior inside. Somehow gets the pass to Liberta. Three from Ham.
Nice play.
Knocks it down.
Liberta really made a nice play stealing the ball from Sender. Passed it out to Ham and got the assist as Ham hit a nice three-point bomb, and then Sender comes back and gets a little bunny down there. So
Lauren Ham, who was asked to prom right after the halftime break, comes out and hits a three.
Oh, that was her?
Yes.
Okay. You got the inside scoop. I'm not in the know around here on that kind of stuff, but that was a nice presentation on that.
Loose ball bouncing around. Ham gets it. Pass to Prawl, who gets tripped by the referee, it looks like. Little smile on her part. Ball goes to Bellingham anyway.
That's a distraction if you get asked to the prom during halftime of your basketball game. But she came back and hit a three-pointer.
Right.
I guess it's working out pretty good.
I guess so. Magerman, the quick three. She knocks it down right in the face of her defender. And a quick answer there for Bellingham.
Beautiful shot. Magerman, she hasn't even come off the court all night.
Ham tries to answer. A bit too strong on that three. Now in the hands of Magerman again. She drives, almost gets her pass taken away. Mantegani open for three. She knocks it down. Six quick points here for Bellingham.
Wow. 27-point lead down to 18 or something like that. It was about 25-point lead.
They might have to employ that three-point shot a little bit more here moving forward.
Oh, nice play.
Great passing here from Hopkinton. Liberta finds Mafior down low, who seals off her defender and gets a nice two-point shot to fall in. 20-point lead now for Hopkinton.
That was a beautiful play. Ball never hit the ground. About five passes in a row, real quick.
Pass inside to Sender, knocked away. Prawl comes away with the loose ball. Ham with it now, looking for help. She does find it. And Liberta, the nice pass to Prawl. Prawl's scoop shot layup goes in.
Wow, Elizabeth Liberta with
picking
her,
up a few quick assists.
Yeah, I mean, she's probably the assist leader at this point. Wow.
Tough shot from
Magerman.
Jesse Magerman.
She's got five quick points. Things are heating up around here.
As the third quarter is coming to a close, just under a minute left, both teams are starting to find the hoop. Ham for three. Off the mark, but Prawl anticipates it and grabs the offensive rebound. Liberta over to Prawl. She's open for three.
Ooh, back rim.
A bit too strong. Good shot, but doesn't fall for Prawl. Figueroa with it now. Gets it in the center. She shakes off their defender.
Whew.
Just muscles through and gets the two-point shot. No shot clock now.
She's had some beautiful shots down that end.
Corby drives, kicks it
five
over.
Seconds.
Prawl, 5 seconds left. Now Liberta looking for help.
It.
Corby for three. Buzzer shot, no good. Sender grabs the rebound, and we end the third quarter here with a 18-point lead for Hopkinton.
Yeah, I say that was a pretty, a lot of scoring going on
in
that.
Yeah, pretty good stretch there.
And again, Bellingham got some tough news. It looks like that one of their big girls, Caitlin Repose, the freshman, she was having a great game. She's on their bench with an ice pack on her head. She really took an elbow, unfortunately, to the forehead or something. And we have the 50-50 raffle here. Let's see if I get a chance here. Mr. Bishop, the principal, not a bad selection. Looks like he's bringing coffee in for the
maybe a conflict of interest
the
here.
The staff for next
I don't
tomorrow
suggest
morning.
Anything.
I don't know. We'll have to see how that goes. But Mr. Bishop, I don't know if that was a fix. I doubt it was.
I'm not suggesting anything.
Well, congratulations to Mr. Bishop, the principal of High School Hopkinton High, who was the 50-50 raffle winner tonight. And just one of the many exciting things happening here in the Athletic Center tonight. Again, I was in the middle of saying that Caitlin Repose, freshman number 21 for Bellingham, she was having a great game, and unfortunately she took that elbow to the head and looks like she might be out for the
night.
Yeah,
it does not look like she will be making her way back in here.
But since she went down, they've hit Bellingham has tightened the score up a little bit, which is kind of an odd thing. But
Liberta again finds McDermott. The shot no good, but McDermott grabs her own rebound. Ham for three, fires it quick, knocks it down. 6 points for Lauren Ham.
Boy, she's on fire the last two games with a three-point land. Liberta with a block.
Now Prawl on the break again. Bellingham switching to a purely man-to-man defense away from their zone. Ham back to Liberta. Liberta drives. Nice play.
Nice.
Two more points for Elizabeth Liberta, the junior.
She's having probably her best game of the season, and that got her whole all of her teammates off the bench on that move.
Travel called there against Bellingham. Now, these girls probably won't play too much in a playoff game if it's close, but if there comes a time where they have to go in, fill a role, if someone gets injured, there's foul trouble, a game like this is a good one to fall back on confidence-wise just to know that they can be out there and help their team win.
Good point. And, you know, these girls are playing the string out here. Oh, nice block. 23. Sydney Connor, a freshman. Again, this team is so young.
Liberta finds McDermott. Nice pass. McDermott finishes. It's got to be close to five or six assists, I think, for Liberta here.
Boy, she's lighting it up. Both ends of the floor. She had to block down the other end.
Looks like Libby Gladue will make her first appearance into this game. With a bit over 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter as a backcourt violation is called.
Libby Gladue is in number 21, as you said, and looks like a point guard.
Oh, looks like Repose is checking in. She
that's a good sign.
Shed the ice pack and is checking in by the scorer's table, so good news there. Mafior, the nice idea, try to get it down to McDermott. She can't control it. Turnover for the Hillers.
Caitlin Repose again entering the game after a little ice pack situation on the bench, and good to see her back in there.
So assuming the Hillers take this one, they will improve to 13-2 on the season, 13-1 in the TVL, a fantastic season. Really any year, but especially this year, a bunch of good teams fighting it out for the top of the division, at which Hopkinton is in first in the TVL. And like you said before, Steve, just looking to fight for a better seed, trying to get some home games here, which would be huge.
Sure. I mean, it looks like they're in a position to get at least one home game. And
I would think so, yeah.
And I'm sure that'll be rocking. And then if they can, you know, get a couple, have the ball bounce their way, then get deep into the playoffs, and maybe they can pull out a championship and have a little parade.
Yeah, I think this team definitely has a chance, though.
Yep, I think you're right.
They have a good balance as Mafior draws the foul and will be shooting two, or Liberta, excuse me. But they have a good mix. of role players, of depth, of their starters providing a bunch of scoring. They don't have to rely exclusively on one player, so I'm really looking forward to big things here from this team.
I would agree. You know, today we had the Patriots parade rolling rally, which was a lot of fun, and maybe just a slightly lesser extent, it would be great to have a
the Hiller parade.
Hiller girl hoop parade, or at least they usually traditionally have a police escort when they get to town, because there's a lot of Hoppington teams win championships. There you go, Elizabeth Roberta with another point. But I don't know if they do that in Medway, but they certainly do the police escort for the championship teams when they enter. Well, it happens a lot in track here, I can tell you that.
Right,
the track,
yes.
The track teams win all the time. So.
Yeah, I did track in high school. I had my fair experience with that.
There you go.
Ham with the shot. Seems like her only two-point shot so far here tonight. No good. McDermott, rebound. She drops it, and she's got to be close to 10 points herself. Ashley McDermott. Now a 61-33 lead for Hopkinton.
So things are opening up a little bit. Timeout by Bellingham. 4:49 left in the game. Just maybe not a bad decision just to gather themselves a little bit.
And Marie Sesnick, number 20, making her first appearance here in this game. Coach Greco really going down to the end of the bench here, getting some typically exclusively JV players getting some chances here today.
Well, that's good, and there's plenty of time for them to get that varsity experience. There's a 28-point lead and just under 5 minutes to go. And, you know, this is sort of one of those games where they're going to, and we've said this a few times in the past, where they have this nice lead, and it's a lot of girls get an opportunity to play. But it looks like there's about 15 girls on
right
over there. I'm not going to sit here and count them, but
like they're sending in hockey lines or something.
It is, and you know, when you look at the Bellingham bench compared to they have literally three girls on the bench compared to 10 on the bench.
Right.
That's a tough situation. I don't know what's happening in Bellingham, but I hopefully their program can
recover
and rebuild on the next couple years.
But as you said, or as you alluded to earlier, this Bellingham team has been fighting the whole time. No chippy play despite the score. Still no heads down. Still trying.
Yep.
Definitely an encouraging performance here against the Hillers. Tough pass there from Sesnick to Gladue. Goes out of bounds, so she can't handle it.
Good idea. That's a little bit too strong in the pass.
Number 34, Cammie McDonald, also making her first appearance here in the game.
Nice pass. Ooh. Uh-oh. That's good.
Sender takes a hard fall to the floor. McDermott helps her up. Seems to be okay.
Looks like she might have turned an ankle. That's the way she reacted, but if it were me, I would have turned my ankle. But she did a nice job, bounced right back up.
Sender
nice
gets
block.
Partially blocked there by McDermott. Great play down low. She finds herself down on the other end. Has to kick it back out. Sesnick drives, blocked by Repose, but she grabs the loose ball and finishes. Marie Sesnick, her first points of the game.
A little party going on. Everybody's scoring here. Got a 30-point
lead. McDermott, great steal. Saw the pass coming from Mantegani, jumped in front of Sender and took it away.
I mean, the box score is like overflowing. Everyone's, you know,
right.
Must have 10 people that scored tonight.
Gladue baseline. Liberta by herself at three. Didn't even think about that one. McDonald now stuck with Sender in front of her. 3 seconds left, but taken away by Magerman. She stops from just inside the three-point line. Off the side of the rim, no good.
Cammie McDonald in, 34.
McDermott's pass almost taken away. Now Liberta with it. She kicks it back out, and the Hillers looking to dribble out the majority of their shot clock here. Sesnick drives, blocked by Repose.
Nice recovery.
She still has it back. 5 seconds left. Turns and fires the three. Oh, getting a signal 2-point shot there, but a great play nonetheless from Sesnick.
Boy, she had a nice recovery. The shot clock was winding down. It was about 3 seconds left, and she launched it.
Yep, she stayed aware of the situation, knew the shot clock didn't reset. gather herself and knock down the deep two. 4 points for her. Pass inside to Sender. She's fouled by McDermott. 65-33, Hiller lead. 2:31 left in the game. Coming in for Bellingham are Sydney Connor and Haley DeSalt. Sender and Figueroa take a seat.
Sender, this is one of the first times she's come out of the game, too. She's had a great game.
And Magerman still hasn't been out. The spark of this Bellingham team.
Yeah, she's kind of kept it together. You can see she's their primary ball handler. And, you know, looking at the Bellingham team, they have one senior, Jade Figueroa, and everyone else is coming back, and they've got some nice players. So I'm sure things will balance out a little bit more for them next year. We'll have to make a note of that and see how it goes next
year.
Right, yeah.
Magerman nice gets her hands in there, takes it away.
Nice pass.
Mantegani from the baseline, too strong. Loose ball grabbed. Great play by DeSalt.
Oh, timeout.
And Coach Bilodeau calls a timeout, tries to save the possession.
Yeah, I think that they saw that she saw that. Yeah, that's to her credit. Coach Bilodeau, there's still 2 minutes left in the game, and you get to play things out, and looked like a potential jump ball situation. So, as you said, she called a quick timeout to maintain possession, and Bellingham will have the ball with about 2 minutes left in the game.
Yeah, sometimes as the coach, you make that call, or you accept making that call, and you go to call a timeout, and you end up getting out of it, which they did there. But still, I'm sure she'd rather have the ball than risk it. Here with 2:08 left, although, as I've said this before, shouldn't impact the final score here as the Hillers have a 32-point lead. And looking very similar to last game's score on January the 6th when Hopkinton won 61-23.
Yeah, there's been a lot of lopsidedness going on here, but you know, what we talked about before the game a little bit, Tim, is you don't want to get too comfortable if you're the Hiller girls.
Right.
With these big blowouts, and you know, it inevitably it's gonna. Oh, nice move by Repose.
Repose, the nice footwork there, knocks down the jumper.
She's only a freshman. She's about 6'1" down there. That's she's gonna be a player to reckon with. But we certainly don't want to see the Hillers get too comfortable. And tonight's a special night. They're getting about 12 or 14 players in. But as the regular season winds down, we want to make sure that they stay competitive and.
Right. You don't want to have to play at your best and not be able to summon up that energy or that attitude.
Right.
But in these past games, no matter what the score is, I have to say I'm impressed with their attitude. That I haven't noticed a drop off in play or anybody not hustling for balls that they otherwise would have gotten. So, I mean, so far I haven't seen any signs of that attitude there from the Hillers. But we'll see when they come and play a close game.
Inevitably.
Maybe against Millis or Medway coming up.
Yep.
A minute 15 left. Liberta turns.
Oof.
Can't
big
finish.
Big collision there. Good left hand, though. Good idea.
Mantegani fires quickly. No good. And McDermott, another rebound. She has to be in double-digit rebounds by now. Sesnak drives, stops.
Nice.
Off the backboard. Great play from Reese Sesnak coming in. Fourth quarter with 6 points.
Well, you know, what was really good about that is she maintained her composure, didn't lose her balance, stop and pop.
Yeah, recognized the right play to make, saw the bigger defender there in front of her, stop, put it off the backboard. Now it looks like a blocking foul called. Bellingham will inbound under the Hiller hoop with 44.9 seconds left. Again, barring any type of miracle here in the last almost 3/4 of a minute. Hopkinton will improve to 13-2, 13-1 in the TVL, and this will make it a double-digit win streak of 10 games in a row now. And Bellingham will drop to 3-14 overall and 1-14 in the TVL with a game against Medway coming up on Friday. Meanwhile, Hopkinton will play at Millis on Tuesday the 10th, on Friday the 10th, excuse me, and then at Medway on the 14th, and then we will be back here in Hopkinton for the last game of the regular season against Westwood.
And you and I will be back for that? Or?
Yes, yes.
Okay, I'll have to double check.
I know I will be.
Well, I got to check with my manager, my wife, Donna.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And make sure the coast is clear, but I think I think I'll be all right.
You better be there for that one.
Well, it's the three. It's, you know, the Valentine's Day is a few days before then, so I think I'll got to make sure I...
You got to handle your business.
Yeah, exactly. And so that's 3 days later. I should be good.
So 10 seconds left here. Hopkinton just passing out the remaining time. No need to shoot. Shot clock is off. And the Hillers improved to 13-2 overall with a 67-35 win over Bellingham and up their win streak to 10 games in a row.
Well, Tim, that was a fun night. We had a prom invitation that went was successful.
Successful, yep.
Lauren Hamm, I don't want to put her on the spot, but she
she came in and hit a couple threes right after that.
It certainly was an effective strategy at halftime for her. She, like you said, she was launching from three-point land. Just an overall really great, fun game. Tuesday night down at the Athletic Center, and there's a few more games to go before the regular season, and looking forward to seeing everyone on the next Friday night here for the next girls' home game. But as you said, we had a couple away games in between.
Right. And just before we go, we want to thank our crew one more time. Producers, John Ritz and Mike Tarosian. Director, Tom Dings. Graphics, Samantha Dings. And on cameras, Bob Hamilton and John Ritz. Thank you guys. And thank the audience for listening to us here tonight in Hopkinton. We hope to see you here next time against Westwood.